Dubai has transformed vast stretches of desert into global business hubs and replaced coastal waters with stunning artificial islands. Its latest infrastructure project targets a challenge less visible but equally complex, moving millions of people seamlessly beneath one of the world's fastest-growing cities. This is the Dubai Loop, a 17-kilometer underground network of high-speed electric vehicles. Announced in February 2025 through a groundbreaking partnership between Dubai's Roads and Transport Authority, RTA, and Elon Musk's The Boring Company, this futuristic transit system will link 11 strategically placed stations. Unlike traditional metro rails, it relies on modified electric vehicles traveling at 160 kilometers per hour through narrow tunnels, promising direct routes with no intermediate stops. With a planned capacity of 20,000 passengers per hour, it aims to complement rather than replace Dubai's existing metro, which currently serves 755,000 daily riders across 89.6 kilometers of track. But why does Dubai need this? How will it actually work? And can a system like this really handle the demand of a rapidly growing city? Let's break it down. Dubai is reaching a critical inflection point. With 3.9 million residents in 2025 and projections suggesting 5.8 million by 2040, surface transportation networks face mounting strain. The metro's red line, which carries 385,000 daily passengers, operates at 92% capacity during peak hours, according to the RTA's 2024 annual report. Meanwhile, road congestion costs Dubai's economy a staggering $1.3 billion annually in lost productivity, per Dubai Economic Department data. The timing aligns with Dubai's broader push under its 2040 Urban Master Plan, which includes expanding pedestrian pathways, developing climate-controlled cycling routes like the Loop, and integrating transit-oriented neighborhoods. While the metro remains the backbone of public transport, the new underground project targets specific congestion points, especially in financial hubs and tourist hotspots where above-ground expansion faces physical and logistical barriers. Dubai's version of the Loop builds upon the Boring Company's experience in Las Vegas, where a similar but smaller-scale system has operated since 2021. The concept is straightforward. Move people point to point through underground tunnels using electric vehicles, bypassing surface traffic entirely. The system consists of two parallel tunnels, each 3.6 meters in diameter, housing modified Tesla vehicles that carry up to 16 passengers. Instead of traditional rails, these vehicles use a flat, electrically powered track system, allowing for smooth acceleration and constant speeds. Phase one of this project focuses on a 17-kilometer route linking Dubai International Financial Center to downtown Dubai, with 9 additional stations serving areas like Business Bay, Dubai Creek Harbor, and Al Jadaf. Capacity hinges on vehicle density, with 200 vehicles operating simultaneously and departing every 15 seconds during peak hours. The system can theoretically transport 20,400 passengers hourly. For perspective, this equals 40% of the Dubai Metro's red line capacity, but requires 80% less underground space due to narrower tunnels. Vehicles will enter and exit stations via parallel side tunnels to avoid disrupting mainline traffic, a design tested in Las Vegas' 2.7-kilometer convention center loop. This is where the loop stands out. While Dubai metro trains average 50 kilometers per hour with frequent stops, loop vehicles maintain 160 kilometers per hour between stations. A trip from DIFC to Dubai Creek Harbor, a 12-kilometer route that takes 30 minutes by car during rush hour, would take 5 minutes underground. The system prioritizes accessibility. Stations include elevators for wheelchair users and real-time arrival displays synchronized with the RTA's Wajhati Journey Planner app. Financially, the project aligns with Dubai's cost efficiency goals. The entire Phase 1 budget of $250 million matches the cost of adding just 5 kilometers to the existing metro. However, scaling this system comes with challenges. The Las Vegas Loop currently transports only 4,000 passengers per hour, and scaling to Dubai's targets requires flawless vehicle coordination. Now, the real question is whether a fleet of small vehicles can truly replace high-capacity trains. That remains the ultimate test. Building tunnels beneath a dense, active city comes with major hurdles. The backbone of the operation is the Boring Company's Proofrock 3 tunnel boring machines, which can dig 12 meters per hour, a pace that lets crews complete 1 kilometer of tunnel every 34 days. These TBMs simultaneously excavate soil and install curved concrete segments to form tunnel walls, leaving a finished diameter of 3.6 meters. By comparison, Dubai metro tunnels measure 5.8 meters wide, requiring more excavation time and material. Modified Tesla vehicles form the transport fleet, each fitted with retractable guide wheels that slot into tracks embedded in the tunnel floor. This hybrid design enables seamless switching between autonomous road driving and guided tunnel mode, reaching 160 kilometers per hour in just 12 seconds. Batteries recharge inductively at stations during 30-second stops, eliminating the need for overhead wires or third rails. Thermal management systems cool both batteries and passenger cabins using liquid-chilled plates, critical for Dubai's summer temperatures that exceed 50 degrees Celsius. Vehicle coordination relies on a distributed control system rather than centralized scheduling. Each car calculates its optimal speed and spacing using onboard sensors and communicates with nearby vehicles via ultra-wideband radio, maintaining a 2.5-second gap between units at full speed. During simulations, this approach reduced collision risks by 40% compared to traditional train signaling systems. Emergency protocols include automated pull-off zones every 500 meters, where malfunctioning vehicles can exit the main tunnel without disrupting traffic flow. Energy efficiency metrics show potential. Each vehicle consumes 180 watt-hours per kilometer per passenger, 30% less than Dubai's metro trains, according to 2024 RTA energy audits. The tunnels themselves incorporate LED lighting that adjusts brightness based on vehicle proximity, cutting power use by 60% versus always-on alternatives. Solar panels atop station entrances offset 15% of the system's energy needs. However, scaling the Boring Company's technology from Las Vegas to Dubai introduces new hurdles. The Vegas Loop's 2.7-kilometer system uses 62 vehicles to move 4,000 passengers hourly. To reach 20,000 passengers per hour, Dubai's system would need over 1,000 vehicles running smoothly, an operational challenge that has never been attempted at this scale. Maintenance logistics for such a large fleet, coupled with Dubai's abrasive desert sand potentially affecting tunnel air quality, remains a big challenge. Unlike metro expansions that require years of disruptive above-ground construction, the Loop's narrow tunnels can be drilled beneath existing roads with minimal street-level impact. Dubai's government expects the Loop to recover 1.2 million working hours annually lost to congestion, translating into millions of dollars in economic value. Strategically, the system boosts two critical sectors that contribute 38% of Dubai's GDP, tourism and finance. By slashing travel time between DIFC and Dubai Mall from 25 minutes by car to just 6, it enhances the city's appeal to international businesses. A 2025 survey by Knight Frank found 73% of firms considering regional headquarters ranked commute times between business districts as a top 3 location factor. For tourists, it links attractions like Burj Khalifa and Dubai Frame with hotels in Business Bay, potentially increasing visitor spending by reducing transit fatigue. Dubai also aims to cut transportation emissions 30% by 2030, and the Loop's electric fleet aligns with this target. Initial projections suggest it could remove 18,000 metric tons of CO2 annually by replacing 60,000 daily car trips per RTA modeling. However, achieving this requires flawless integration with last-mile solutions, a challenge given that 58% of Dubai Metro users still rely on cars or taxis for first last-mile connections, according to a 2024 RTA mobility survey. The system's modular design offers strategic flexibility. Future phases could extend tunnels to Expo City Dubai or Al Maktoum International Airport without requiring centralized infrastructure upgrades, a key advantage over rail systems. This scalability positions the Loop as a test case for rapid transit solutions in cities where population growth outpaces traditional planning cycles. The 2018 Dubai Metro study showed a return of approximately 44 cents per dollar invested initially, rising to about $1.17 per dollar by 2030. The Loop needs similar long-term commitment, a challenge given its reliance on unproven scaling of the Boring Company's technology. With 62% of Phase 1's budget allocated to untested automation systems, financial auditors flag potential cost overruns. But as with any bold infrastructure project, risks remain. While the RTA and the Boring Company signed their partnership in early 2025, Neither has committed to specific construction phases or opening dates. Dubai's history of reshaping geography, from desert to skyscrapers, ocean to islands, now extends underground. For now, it offers a glimpse into a future where cities dig deeper to keep people moving. So, will this mega project succeed? Is this the future of urban transportation? Or is Dubai taking a gamble on unproven technology? Let me know what you think in the comments.